Hey kids, welcome back again to Ken Tamplin Vocal Academy, where the proof is in the singing. I am continuing my series called Then and Now. Next up, Bon Jovi. Let's do this. Here we go. This is Then. Now, I have to say, I've seen Bon Jovi a few times, and I have to say, a lot of that sounded kind of like Def Leppard-y being on tracks. I know that Elliot sang in the microphone a lot of the time, and I'm not saying everything was on track, just like I'm not saying everything that Jon Bon Jovi did was on tracks. But you could kind of hear that there was a lot of too perfectness, not only to the sound, but some of the double tracking that was involved, and also the quality of the sound of a live microphone compared to a studio microphone. So you heard other elements coming in along for the ride. So I don't want to oversell his awesomeness, though he was exceptional in his day. But there was also a lot of production that helped along with the band and so forth. So now, again, I remember seeing him live, and I remember him talking to the audience. I remember singing different things, whatever. I'm not saying it was all on tape, but I'm saying there was certainly a help. Okay. So as we move on from that, I want to be clear about at least that clip. Let's move on. Here we go. This is Now. Well, obviously that wasn't that great. I know some of the sync is off on some of this because we had to kind of match up some video to some audio to get it to fly for YouTube to allow us to use it. As we all know, John has suffered a lot vocally, especially over the last, I don't know, 5, 6, 7 years or whatever. And personally, that didn't need to happen. It didn't. I talk with my students all about this. It did not need to happen. And what I do with my students is I go through a regimen of all kinds of things, from taking collagen, you know, because the vocal folds are made of collagen, to different stretching exercises that we do in order to be able to maintain good elasticity, good moisture in the cords, the resiliency of the cords themselves. And also when the cord itself gets old and it starts to atrophy over time like this, and becomes really hardened, like a rubber band that's not oiled or anything like that's elastic sort of sensation, we really need to put that moisture and elasticity back in the cords themselves and then exercise them with regularity. And if we don't, it gets stiff and hard. And that is precisely what you're hearing right now with John. Now, John is a cool guy and he's had amazing music. He's been an inspiration to me, influence on my life and my big anthemic choruses that I've written on my records over the years. But that is what's happened, and he did not take care of his voice, and we're seeing a direct byproduct of that. Now, other people say, well, Ken, can you fix him? You know, it would take a while to rehabilitate the cords. A lot of people get their cords cut because they want them to go back to a higher placement. The smaller the cord, the higher usually the placement, not always. But in his case, more of it is about agility training and rehabilitating the agility in the folds themselves. And that would take quite some time, probably at least a year or more to do it right. So can it be done? Yeah, to a large extent it could be, with a regimen and, you know, a dietary regimen and also a physical regimen for the voice, but he has to want it, and I don't know if he does, so that's up to him. Anyway, let's continue. Here we go. This is Then. Kind of interesting, you know, Sambora, it's like having two lead singers in the band. He really helped out a lot with like co-lead singing certain parts. When John wasn't able to hit certain things, Richie would step up to the plate. You know, he really bailed John out quite a few times live. I've seen that, which is cool. I mean, we want that. We need that kind of support. So, you know, he had a really great support team behind him. So anyway, this is Now. Sorry. found my side, right? It's kind of singer's old man's disease. And what happens with that, again, is I want to back this up. I'll explain this. As the cricoarytenoid and thyroid cartilage pull like this, they actually stretch the folds. And when the folds won't stretch, or they kind of get locked up in different directions, this happens with the cartilage and with the connectors in the cartilage, or you know, the connecting the cartilage to, from top to bottom. They get kind of robotic and stiff. So, hands on my side, right? And this is precisely what we're hearing here, is the inability for the folds themselves to release and to relax into a state of resiliency, and to have the cricoarytenoid and the thyroid cartilage be able to pull with an ebb and flow and releasing that. Now, what you do is you exercise that. You start carefully, and then you use a lot of things that, you know, you stay hydrated, you take collagen, you do these things, and then you stretch these over time, and you can get that elasticity back. It's like a rubber band that's just old, and you oil it, and you kind of mess with it, and you oil it a little more, and you mess with it, you oil it a little more. If you're not careful and you snap it, you can actually snap sinews of collagen, which your folds are made of hundreds and hundreds of sinews of collagen. So you can actually get that back. It just takes some time, and as we age, it takes longer to get it back. You have to warm your voice up longer. You have to just be more fragile and careful with it. But anyway, let's continue. Here we go. I mean, at that point, I kind of think it's time to retire if you're not going to rehabilitate your voice, or maybe sing some country songs. I'm going low. I'm a cowboy on a steel horse I ride, right? Because that's kind of really where your voice is at that point. But anyway, gang, thank you for joining me, and definitely stick around for my next video.